Guys, I would be straight up lying to you if I said that I had not been highly anticipating new Blink-182 music for a while now. And it's finally time for a track review of new Blink-182 music. Seemingly off of an album called California that should be out this summer, the new song, Bored to Death. They had been teasing it on their Instagram, and today, as you saw from the screenshot that I included at the start of this video, it seems like they uploaded it as unlisted. My friend Hannah was kind enough to send it my way before it got taken down. You guys can probably still find it floating out there somewhere. I will try to include a link to hear it, or it's probably, by the time you're watching this video in the future sometime, probably already officially released, so I will include updated links so that you can stream it. Blink-182 are back with Bored to Death, and it's a song that definitely starts off with this nice bass groove, kind of a fast-paced bass groove that reminds me of some of their earlier work. It's definitely something that you hear it and you instantly think of Blink, and that's something that I can say is a very good thing, especially because there's a lot of doubters out there. Tom DeLonge, no longer in this band, Matt Skiba of Alkaline Trio, Matt Skiba and the Secrets, very, very talented musician, has stepped into the role, and I like that it's a Mark Hoppus-led song to kind of ease fans into it. Yes, Skiba is adding in these extra harmonies. Yes, it sounds really tight, and Hoppus sounds great. In fact, some of my favorite Blink-182 songs are Mark Hoppus song tracks, and I think that he's doing a great job here of just bringing this attitude of like life and death and just not really finding where your passion lies, not knowing exactly what to do. And it's a storytelling song. I think that they're doing some reminiscing here, and I like seeing them do that. It's got a very big chorus. Hold your breath. I'm sorry. Save your breath. I'm nearly bored to death. It's got one of those things that definitely has that John Feldman touch to it. He's known for kind of making like bigger anthem-styled songs, and I think that he has struck gold with that once again here. And Blink-182, no stranger to that big anthemic feeling song, of course. And this one is just a little bit different. I like that they are taking something that's down a different path, but at the same time, up a similar vein, if that makes sense at all. You can definitely note Travis Barker's drumming here. It's definitely steady all throughout, and I love kind of the drum fills going on the outro and just a little drum solo almost. Can't say that I'm a fan of all of the type vocals that kind of carry this song out, but that's really the only complaint that I have here. I think it's a very, very catchy song, a very clever song from a lyrical point of view, and I think it's something that most fans will probably enjoy. It's something that's going to tide them over until the album comes out for sure, because I know I will be looping this on repeat. I already have been since I got my hands on it this afternoon. If you guys have heard it, let me know your thoughts on it in the comment section down below. Are you enjoying the guitars and everything about it here? I'm just loving the musicality of this track. It's a little bit darker, a little bit edgier, but still very, very melodic. One of those moments that I could see just being a staple of this upcoming Blink-182 album. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Smash the like button on this video if you did enjoy my track review here. Check the song out for yourself in the description. You can find me on Twitter at ARTVReviews to stay up with, everything Blink-182 related that I might be thinking or other thoughts that might fly out of this head. You never know what's going to come next. Thanks for watching and subscribing. I will see you guys very, very soon right here on Beyond ARTV.